Blackstone Audiobooks presents True North by Jim Harrison. This book bears the following dedication: to Judy Hottinson and Amy Huntley. Father was wailing. I deduced from the morning sun and moving flotsam that we were drifting slowly southward with the force of an unknown current. He slumped on the back seat of the wooden rowboat, and I leaned forward, grabbing his shirt to keep him from pitching overboard. Both of his hands had been severed at the wrist, and the stumps had been tightly bound with duct tape. His normally withered forearms now bulged with an unsightly color. When they had pushed us out from the estuary on a falling tide before dawn, I had been given only one oar. When I clearly noted this at first light, the humor wasn't lost on me. I was equipped to row in circles with my left hand. The thumb of my right hand was missing, and the pain lessened when I raised it high. In the early light, I had seen a green or loggerhead turtle, and took my thumb, someone had stuffed in my pocket, pitching it toward the beast, but the turtle had submerged in alarm, misunderstanding my good intentions. By mid-morning the shore had arisen, and I could see the coastline south of Veracruz. The current was carrying us toward Alvarado. My father woke from his latest faint. His face was too bruised for clear speech, and now, rather than wailing, he bleated. His eyes made his request clear, and I pushed him gently over the back of the boat. It was quite some time before he completely sunk. I would study the stinking fish scales and bits of dried viscera on the boat's bottom, and then look up, and he would still be there, floating in the current. And then finally I was pleased to see him sink. What a strange way to say goodbye to your father. Part 1. 1960s. Chapter 1. My name is David Burkett. I'm actually the fourth in a line of David Burketts beginning in the 1860s, when my great-grandfather emigrated from Cornwall, England, to the upper peninsula of Michigan, which forms the southern border of Lake Superior, that vast inland sea of fresh water. This naming process is of no particular interest, except to illustrate how fathers wished to further dominate the lives of their sons from the elemental beginnings. I have done everything possible to renounce my father, but then within the chaos of the events of my life it is impossible to understand the story without telling it. My father was so purely awful that he was a public joke in our area, but with his having moved to Duluth so long ago the jokes had become quite stale, truly ancient, and were now being raised to life only by older men, mostly retired, sitting near the breakwall in the public park next to Lake Superior, watching boats they never boarded going in and out of the harbor. Perhaps it is strange for a victim of evil to see this evil become more local folklore than a vital force, but then I was a temporary victim, abandoning both my parents at age 18 when I had the strength of my anger, though I admit my sister Cynthia, at age 16, beat me to the punch by a full month. Cynthia got herself pregnant by her lover, a mixed-blood Finn and Chippewa, Anishinaabe Indian, the son of our yardman, who was a senior to her sophomore and a star on the Marquette High School football team. At the time, 1966, for a girl of Cynthia's social standing to get herself pregnant by an Indian boy would be the same as a girl from a prominent Mississippi family becoming pregnant from an affair with a black man. In animal terms, Cynthia could be likened to a wolverine, the most relentlessly irascible beast in North America, whereas I, in my teens, was more an opossum who wished to be a bear. Not oddly, it was a grotesque and unprosecuted crime committed by my father that drove us away, but then I have to work up to this dire event. I'm too impatient to start at the beginning, and besides, no apparent God knows when that might be. I'm averse to the mirror in my cabin toilet, having long ago unscrewed the single light bulb, but since the toilet is on the north side...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.